Welcome back. Well, we want to put your face.
Your best face.
Okay, because it said beat face.
Yeah,
in there.
I got what and they were talking about.
And I was like, what? So we want to put your best face forward for the weekend, right? Dr. Andrew
Absolutely.
Newman here with us this morning.
Thanks.
Thank you for being here. I appreciate it. So we were talking about this earlier. It seems like when you have like one of those really big blemishes coming on, you can kind of feel it, right?
Yeah.
So what, I mean, what should you do when you feel, say you've got a big job interview, you've got a big date or something, you're just
wedding.
Trying to, I want to tamp this thing down before it gets started. Is there any way to do that?
So what most people do if they have a very important event like a wedding or you're going on live TV, you can come into the office and actually see one of us, and we can do some procedures, for example, a little injection of an anti-inflammatory into it. That's not something that I advise for everyone just to go ahead and do.
That's
but
what
it's
you can
an
know.
Option.
It's an emergency procedure.
Right.
Like you said, you're a bride, and it's like right in the middle of your forehead.
It's not like every Friday. Like I'm going out on Friday night with the girls.
Hey,
Dr. Andrew, I got to see you.
Right. It's good to know that you can do that. Okay, so on an everyday basis, you know, you just don't want to show up to work with a big white head on your face.
Right, so for the most part, it's more about prevention than it is for treatment. When you see a pimple popping up, the best thing you can do is just do a gentle cleanser. You can do some cover-up, make sure it's non-comedogenic, meaning it's not going to cause more pimples, put it in the makeup.
Well, how do you know if that is?
It should say that on the product.
Oh, really?
What about compresses, like cold or hot? Like, you know, I always read that it was like a hot compress to open up your pores.
Yeah, either or might help.
Okay.
That can be tried too. Okay.
I see you got some stuff down here. What is this?
So over here we have
some
gentle cleansers, and we have some examples of a
product
for makeup, and that's non-comedogenic.
Okay, so that'll say that on the label. So this is something. So let's say you've got something popping up and you do have one of those whiteheads. And I know my wife is always on me. You're going to leave that just sitting there like that, but I don't want to pop it. You just cover it up a little bit. And
exactly.
The deal.
And that's manly enough, isn't it? Your skin looks pretty good.
Can a guy do that?
Yeah.
I don't have a lot of them. And this is just like just regular facial cleansers.
Gentle cleanser, right. It's not a harsh soap.
Over the counter. I've seen this at
the
store. Yeah.
You don't need to go see a dermatologist for that, although we do have that in our offices typically.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
okay, what's this here?
So these are some medicines that we typically use to treat acne. This one is actually over the counter, the Panoxyl there. There's some other ones there that are prescription. And so these are just some examples of acne medicines that we use very, very commonly.
Do they work?
Acne. They work really well. They don't work overnight. And that's why it's so important to do a preventative approach for acne, because this is a month to month type of treatment, not you see a pimple and you treat it that day.
So let me ask you, because I have a tween daughter, she's 12, and that is right around the age of puberty. Mm-hmm. What do you recommend for parents with children in that age group? Anything like something like this in the middle portion, or it's just regular?
I think all of these that we've discussed is important. You want to take a preventive approach with the gentle cleansers.
Right.
You can come see a dermatologist if you want to get on a treatment regimen. There's no age restriction on starting acne regimens by any means.
Oh, okay.
Okay. We might use different medicines, of course, but there's no restriction.
Mm. What's this last one here?
So the last one, we can't have a dermatology talk without talking about sunscreen. It's just not going to happen, right?
Right?
So this is a great sunscreen that will actually protect your skin from the sun while not causing more pimples. So this is also non-comedogenic. It's a great
is there
example.
Something like I've heard there's like a titanium something or other oxide or something. Again, there's an ingredient you should look for. Is that right?
So titanium oxide. This is a mineral sunscreen. It's not a chemical sunscreen. So it deflects the sun rays rather than absorbing them.
Mm-hmm.
There's some advantages and disadvantages to these different types of sunscreens. I don't think in terms of acne it makes too much of a difference.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
So I think it is a good opportunity, and you just brought this up. I know I like to get out in the sun. I think a lot of people who move here to Arizona, we have so many people moving here, they want to be outdoors. They want to enjoy themselves. Sunscreens are important. I get checked out once a year. You know, you strip down top to bottom.
Right.
How important is that to have a dermatologist like you?
Very important. Okay. We don't want people to be vampires and staying in all the, you know, every day of the year. We want people to enjoy the quality of their life outside.
Yeah.
That's why we live here in Arizona. So coming in every year for a skin check can at least protect you in the long run from developing skin cancers. If you do have one, we'll take care of it early.
And maybe give you some peace, right? You know exactly what's going on. You
definitely.
Talk to somebody about it.
Definitely.
Thank you. Great job. You're good on TV. How do people get a hold of you if they need to?
So we have, I have business cards, and then also we have an office phone number.
Are you on? Are you online somewhere?
So we are online, absolutely, affiliated Dermatology.
Okay.
And you can reach us via phone, you can reach us via even email and whatnot. So
Nice meeting you.
Yeah, good nice job. To meet you too. Yeah. You have good skin.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, look at it. Yeah.